Hi everyone, welcome back to the channel. Today we'll be talking about the non-carious lesion. So as the name suggests, non-carious lesion is something in which there is loss of tooth surface, there is loss of tooth structure, but it is not related to exactly caries. So different type of non-carious lesions which we are going to talk about is attrition, abstraction, erosion and abrasion. So let's move to the definition of the non-carious lesion. In general, non-carious lesions are defined as loss of dental tissue. So there is loss of dental tissue at the cemento-enamel junction or near the cemento-enamel junction, but it is not relatively to the tooth decay. It is not related to the tooth decay exactly. So there can be different types. I just told you abrasion, erosion, abstraction and attrition. Moving to the first type, that is attrition. So look at the picture first. What is the difference which you can see in this picture as compared to a normal tooth? There is this lines kind of projections here which is there, right? This is only known as attrition. So attrition, always remember, is physiological wear away of tooth, okay? Whenever there is physiological wear away of the tooth substance, that is said to be attrition. It is usually occurring because whenever you apply masticatory forces, whenever mastication process is going on, your maxillary tooth are coming in contact with the mandibular tooth. And so there is a regress pressure which is applied on these tooth surfaces which come in contact to each other, and because they come in contact to each other very often, this leads to attrition. Now what are the normal sites where attrition can occur? It can occur at incisal edge, it can occur on the occlusal surface of molars and premolars, and on the proximal surfaces. So actually saying attrition is normally a age-related disorder. When a person is having masticatory forces applied on the tooth for a really long period of time, or when the maxillary teeth are coming in contact with the mandibular teeth very often from a very long period of time, then only attrition is usually seen. It is seen almost at the above the age of 35 years. So this can be one thing, that in normal conditions, old age people manifest this condition. But sometimes, like in conditions of amelogenesis imperfecta or dentinogenesis imperfecta, which are actually developmental disturbances, can be said that they are congenital problems. In these cases also, attrition can be seen. But in a normal person, it usually occurs in the old age. So you see, to the clinical feature of identification, very, very important. If a patient is sitting in front of you on the dental chair, how are you going to identify that whether it is attrition or abrasion or erosion? So the only feature you have to keep in mind is there will be appearance of facet. Small polished facet will be there. Now what are facet? You see these line kinds of structure on the incisal edge, they are said to be facets. So whenever they are present on the tooth surface, it is a case of attrition. Now what is the etiology or causes of attrition? So usually tobacco consuming people who are addicted to tobacco or patients who are having bruxism are the two which are commonly affected by attrition. So what exactly is bruxism? I hope you all know. Bruxism is a CNS disorder in which the patient grinds the tooth surface again and again. So the maxillary tooth surfaces are coming in contact with the mandibular tooth surfaces, and there is a grinding moment there, especially at the night time, which can lead to wear off of the enamel. Now always keep this in mind that this attrition is more common in males than the females. So it is not common in the females but in the males. So in severe cases, the enamel wash off and the dentine is visible, so it gives a yellowish brownish appearance. As you can see in the figure itself, there is this yellow and light brownish kind of appearance on the tooth surfaces. It is because now the enamel has completely washed off. The enamel layer is very, very thin and the dentine is now actually exposed. And you all know that dentine is brown in color. So that is the reason it is imparting this yellowish and brownish color, because whenever there is going to be attrition, there will be the first tooth structure loss which will be there is enamel itself. And after enamel is left very thin, it will lead to this yellow color. Now moving to another non-carious lesion, that is abrasion. Now as we talked about attrition, we were talking that it is a physiological wear away of the tooth structure, whereas abrasion is a pathological wear away of the tooth structure. So as you can see in the figure, it is mainly at the root portion that the enamel is missing. it is at the root portion mainly. So the clinical identification feature here will be that the roots will be exposed generally in the case of abrasion. The sites where it can normally occur is proximal and the incisal surface. Moving to the etiology, so the very initial etiology of abrasion is that vigorous tooth brushing. So if you are a right-handed person, it is a fact that always you're going to apply more pressure on the left side of your dentition. And if you're a left-handed person, then you're going to apply more pressure on the right side of your teeth. So that is the reason that abrasion is mainly seen on the opposite side of your brushing. And this is one cause of abrasion, that is vigorous or harsh tooth brushing. Another situation I want you to notice here is whenever there is a case of abrasion, there can be, not every time, but maximum of the time, there can be a condition which is known as notching. Okay, you can see this term here, notching. So generally when you have a case of abrasion, you also manifest a case of notching. Now what is actually notching? If you generally see a tooth structure, it is like this, straight. And here in the figure you can see that the incisal edge is not straight, but it is like this. So this loss of tooth structure from this particular surface is said to be a notch. Now what can be the reasons of this notch? The opening of bobby pins from mouth, maybe carpenters and all these people, they hold nails and pins many a time. The tailors, they hold pins from their teeth. That can be another reason for notching of the tooth structure. Then you see pipe drinkers who are habitual smokers, they drink pipe and hookahs, can be another reason for this. Then bad dental flossing can be another reason. Sometimes people do not know exactly how they have to use a floss and it can lead to notching. Another times you see that patients have this habit of using a toothpick, which can be another great reason for notching. So this is the etiology of notching and ultimately leading to abrasion. Now it is majorly seen in males than in the females, as I just told you. This is again a condition which is seen more in case of males than in the females. The dentine is exposed in the later conditions, similar to attrition. So what here occurs is, and which is a characteristic feature, is that whenever there is loss of enamel and the dentine is exposed, the dentinal tubules are also exposed. And whenever the dentinal tubules are exposed, it can lead to sensitivity. Okay, you know that whenever the dentinal tubules are being exposed, it leads to sensitivity. So this sensitivity is actually healed, or kind of, it's not actually healed, but you can say that it is stopped from progressing further by formation of secondary dentine in the mouth. So as soon as the dentinal tubules are affected, or the dentinal tubules get exposed, there is formation of secondary dentine which initiates, and this secondary dentine in future is going to protect the pulp. Otherwise, if this dentine is not formed, ultimately a time will come that even the pulp is going to get affected. Now coming to the next feature, or the next non-carious lesion, that is abfraction. So it is a kind of tooth loss where it is more confined to the gingival area. So whenever there is tooth loss which is more towards the gingival area, it can be manifested as a case of abfraction. So what is the etiology? General etiology which we have is hard tooth brushing. So that is the reason it is suggested never to be very harsh on your tooth surfaces. Now you see, it is in this situation usually the teeth gets flexed again and again, which leads to chipping of the enamel from the buccal surface. So what happens is, for example, you have this burger or a sandwich in front of you, and again and again, like you're taking meals 3 times a day, again and again when you take a bite of the food, your teeth are getting flexed. Flexed means they are moving forward. So every time your teeth is getting flexed, it is leading to chipping of the enamel. It leads to chip off of the enamel, and finally the enamel gets completely removed of an area and the dentine is being exposed, and it mainly occurs from the buccal surface only. Now as you see in the diagram, there is various shapes of abfraction which can occur. It can be a wedge shape like this, it can be a saucer shape, or it can be a mixed shape in which you have both wedge-shaped non-carious lesion or a saucer-shaped non-carious lesion. So these are the types of abfraction lesions you have. Moving to the last non-carious lesion, which is very, very common, that is erosion. Now, erosion is a irreversible loss of dental hard tissues, mainly due to the chemical intake. Many a time, people can confuse this situation with dental caries. But always remember that here, the loss is taking place due to chemical intake, okay? And this is again an irreversible condition similar to the caries. And here also, the dental substances are getting, the hard tissues of the teeth is getting lost. So what exactly happens is, whenever you consume some chemical intake or whenever you consume something acidic, there is that acidic substance will go and act on your tooth, and then the demineralization will occur ultimately. So what can be the causes of erosion? There can be two causes. It can be an extrinsic cause or it can be a intrinsic cause. So if I talk first about the intrinsic cause, that is what is happening inside your body. So GERD is the first cause. GERD is the gastroesophageal reflux disease. In this disease, what happens is that the HCl usually comes back to the esophagus, and in chronic condition can even come in your oral cavity. And so it is, the HCl is coming in contact with the tooth surfaces and it can lead to erosion. Another disease, you know, certain people have this habit of easily vomiting, then frequent vomiting can also lead to erosion. If people have eating disorders, they will ultimately have more vomiting case, and these eating disorders can be anorexia or bulimia. So in these conditions also, there is vigorous vomiting and frequent vomiting which occurs, which can lead to erosion. Another feature which we have, or another cause which we have, is the extrinsic cause, which means something which is coming from the environment. The cold drinks you drink, I hope you all know, the cold drinks you consume are acidic in nature. The energy drink or the sports drink, sometimes when you consume a lot of citrus fruits, bad maintenance of the oral hygiene, harsh tooth brushing, and even the acidic medicines which you take can be a cause of erosion. Now, which are the tooth which are usually affected? So if I see in case of erosion, then many teeth are affected, but usually the lingual surface of the maxillary anteriors are the ones which are affected. But erosion is something which can even affect whole of your dentition, okay? So you can say that most of the teeth are prone to this particular non-carious lesion. When we come to abrasion, then many teeth are affected again, usually the facial surface of maxillary left canine. Remember, the facial surface of the maxillary left canine and the molar regions in right-handed persons. And now talking about effraction, may occur in single tooth. So effraction is usually seen in one single tooth. Abrasion is usually seen in left canine of maxilla. And the erosion can affect many tooth surfaces at a time, mainly the maxillary, lingual surface of maxillary anteriors. Now coming to the treatment of all these non-carious lesions, you can suggest patient to go for fluoride containing mouthwashes. If there is a lot of loss of tooth structure like enamel and dentine, you can go for restorations, and the major restorations we use is composite and the GIC. Then you can give prosthesis and removable splints to the patients of bruxism. These will kind of lock the jaw and will prohibit the movement of jaw, especially in the night time, so intrusion can be controlled. RCT in severe exposure of pulp cases, and desensitizing toothpaste, which will prevent sensitivity. So if you like the video, please like the button and share the video with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much.